just like the fame.
Fame.
Basically, the fame, man.
I write Bane, I'm on Damn Crew, RM, Rocket Man, 727, from Miami. I've been writing for about 12 years. I like the art in the street better. Like, people who could actually do it in the street and catch a name for that, like, I think they have more merit for their work. It's more genuine, it's closer to what it's about, you know, like graffiti in general. Like.
Gambino niggas who swipe this, deluxe rap cavaliers, bitches who still biz, give me this. Sit back, jollying, my team be gaming like three club mollying, drugs, Somalians, volleying, knitted rap, stay crocheting, ayo, iron, these niggas portraying, but happy paying, for real, slide on these niggas like fresh piss, he's a face now, usually tough grenade, throw a plate, fuck getting late, guzzle this shit like Gatorade, day to day, Wally's have nothing.
Part of me, you know, that's all about fame and destruction. Like, I love bombing, I love destroying the streets, I love just fucking shit up.
My name is Fuse, RM 727 GOK. For myself, I mean, there's not really a message that I'm trying to get across. It's just a creative outlet. I mean, the way that you're thinking at the time and the shit that you're going through kind of defines the way that your letters are coming out and the way that the wall's coming out. And then, I mean, as far as the overall theme for the wall, it's just getting together with the people you're going to paint with and decide what you want to do, you know.
Mic check. We had no static over Illmatic. I reached for it. This nigga said I couldn't have it. So tragic for him to try to counter my magic. I'm rabid. Reach through his fucking face and grab it. Nigga, how the fuck did you figure you could interfere with the music so potent? Then I gazed at his skull for a moment before I moved on. Then I heard two songs.
Illegal piecing, illegal bombing, you run many risks. You run the risk of, which has happened to me, getting caught by, business owner or something like that, painting a back of a building or something, and then they come out and defend their property. I mean, it's their right, obviously. You know, I've gone to paint freights, been chased, been caught in situations, you know, been in situations where, you know, a lot of people would wish they were never in, and I've actually been lucky enough to, you know, just basically get written down, you know, slap on the wrist.
My name is Hector Alfonso. I'm a gang intelligence specialist with the Miami-Dade Police Department. The Florida State statute is very specific when it comes to gangs. A gang is three or more members actively, when two or more of the members are actively conducting criminal activity. They have a common name, they have common identifiers. These graffiti crews fall into that criteria because they give themselves names. There's usually two or three of them, four or five of them, sometimes up to 10. And the criminal activity is the criminal mischief and the vandalism by the graffiti that they perpetrate, painting the side of these buildings, some of the dangerous things they do, painting street signs, painting the overpasses on expressways. When we do find a guy or some of these crews, you know, they're going to be arrested. They're going to be arrested depending on how many counts of vandalism, how many tags they can give up. And the worst thing is that some of the leads that we get on graffiti artists are given to us by other graffiti artists. They're all known. I think at times they don't realize the damage that they incur.
My stuff nowadays is off of permission walls, I guess they call it. More or less going to a business, asking them if they would give us permission to do something for them. maybe something relevant to their business. If not, they would just let us go off on the wall and do what we want to do. We did a mural similar to this in 98, and these guys just went and painted over the whole fucking thing. So now we've had beef with them ever since that happened. And their crews, they keep adding crews that hate us. Like, one crew will hate us, and then they'll hook up with another crew, and then that crew will automatically hate us.
Is about the art, and I think it's about getting your name out there, getting fame, and it's really like, it's like an addiction. Propaganda, force fed to the populace. My thoughts run the gamut from outstanding to preposterous. On top of this, I move posterior from impoverished to posterous. A process accomplished through perseverance. Every man's not my brother, regardless of appearance. Apprehension clouds of spirit. Tension prepares us for ascension. And at his best is when he breaks chains of convention. Chains of convention. The point is to get somebody to see you, to notice what you've done, take picture of what you did, you know. I basically, a lot of the things that I've done have been basically for myself, you know, basically self-gratification, take a picture of it for myself, and if somebody sees it, cool, you know, then I can brag about it later, I guess.